class students, welcome to our online class. This is Nisha Ajesh. Today we are going to study social studies. As we have started our chapter, we know that we haven't completed the first chapter, so we are going to continue first chapter. I hope you remember all what we have learned in the previous classes. Do you remember the name of our first chapter? The name of our first chapter is Earth and the Solar System. The name of our first chapter is the Earth and the Solar System. We have covered up so many topics in this chapter, and we have learned about the celestial bodies. Then we have learned about the universe. We have learned about the stars. We have learned about the constellation. We have learned about the solar system, the sun, planets and their motions, galaxies, such as so many things we have learned, and we started about our Earth, the unique planet. So that was the last chapter, Earth, the unique planet, and at the same time we studied about the satellites also. Okay, now we are going to start a new topic from this chapter, and that is Moon. Okay, so Moon is the today's topic, and as we all know that we when you look into the sky at night, you can see so many things such as stars and the moon, and among the such as celestial bodies, Moon is the biggest thing which we see on the sky. Okay, so Moon is the largest and brightest thing in the sky. Moon is the largest and brightest thing in the sea. If somebody asks you a questions, you can say what is the largest and brightest thing you see in the sky. You can answer that Moon is the largest and brightest thing we see in the sky. Okay, so why do we see Moon as a very big and large? Because it is not it's not like that. See, all other celestial bodies are very small and Moon is big. Not such as Moon is the very closest thing. Moon is very closer to the Earth than any other celestial bodies. Moon is the very closest thing than any other celestial bodies to the Earth. That is why we see Moon as the largest thing on the Earth. Okay, now we have already studied that all the celestial bodies, all the planets and even the planets and their satellites move around the sun, isn't it? It rotates around the sun and it can have a revolution also. Okay, now the moon revolves around the sun in once in 27 days and 8 hours. So once when moon rotates the sun, Moon takes 27 days and 8 days 27 days and 8 hours to complete one rotation to the Earth. Okay, to the sun. Okay, now at the same time we have learned that there are two motions. One is rotation and the other one is a revolution. Okay, so the rotation takes 27 days and 8 hours to complete one rotation. At the same time for the Moon is the rotation and the revolution take the same time period of time. The rotation and the revolution take the same period of time. That means one rotation takes 27 days and 8 hours. At the same time, the revolution also takes 27 days and 8 hours. So that is how when we calculate, we can understand that the Moon take the rotations take period time period of time and the revolutions period of time, both are same for the Moon. Okay. Now here is a picture. Okay, you can see in your textbook here. If you have textbook, you can have a look. See, it's here. Okay, here is the picture given, and it says that when you look into it, you can understand that. You might have heard about full moon and new moon, isn't it? Okay, what is a full moon? So full moon is when you look see a moon in a full face, you say that this is a full moon. Okay, sometimes you think that when you look into the sky, can you see every day moon on the sky? No, we can't see every day moon on the sky. We see some few days we can see and few days we can't see. So the days which we can see moon on the sky, we call that day is a Purnima or full moon day. and the days which we can't see the moon on the sky, we say that is a we call them amavasya or is known as a new moon. Okay, now see, here is a picture given. In this picture, when you look into this picture, you can understand that see, here it starts. Okay, here it starts. When you look these pictures, you can understand that. See, only one face of the moon gets sun light. Okay, moon does not have its own light; it reflects the light of the sun. Okay, so only one part of the moon continuously get the light. That's why when it rotates, some days we can't see the moon on the sky. Okay, and now the sun always lights up one side of the moon, as but the moon moves around the earth. We only see a part of this. These are called faces of moon. Below here you can see one more picture here, the faces of the moon. Okay, so sometimes we see full moon on the high sky. Sometimes we see half moon, like a crescent on the sky. Sometimes we don't see moon at all in the sky. So this is because only one part of the moon gets light. Okay, so and it is rotates too. Okay, when it rotates too, the part which does not get the light, so on those days we can't see the moon in the sky. Okay, so that's where, see, there is no life on the moon. Okay, the third point is, there is no life on the moon. Why there is no life on the moon? Okay, as we have studied in the previous classes, I said that the earth is the only planet where there is life. Okay, so why the reasons also I have told you. The earth is the only planet which supports life, because of the only in the earth we can see atmosphere, water, air and light, isn't it? So because the temperature of the earth, to sustain the life on somewhere else, it need a moderate temperature. Okay, so to sustain your life somewhere else, it can be a plant, it can be an animal, human beings, anything, to sustain the life, it need a moderate temperature. So the temperature of the moon in the day is 100 degrees Celsius, which is not suitable for the living things. Okay, so the daytime, the average temperature for the living things is 22 degrees Celsius. So compared to the 22 degree with 100 degrees, it is so much higher than the normal temperature. So the normal temperature of the moon in the day is 100 degrees Celsius, so that life cannot sustain on that. Okay, the night temperature is minus 150 degree at the night. So the temperature is not suitable for the living things. That is why there is no life on the moon. Okay, so in the moon, the surface of the moon is covered with a mixture of gases and rocks. So when you look into the moon, we can't see only a whitish part, and we cannot understand whatever in there. But the scientist says that the surface of the moon is covered with the mixture of rocks and the dust. Okay, and at the same time, it has a circular depression called the craters. Okay, so there are rocks, they are there, dusts are there, and at the same time there is a circular depression which is called a craters. Okay, so now we have seen so many pictures of the moon, and we have heard that people goes to the moon, and during the 1960, many spacecraft were sent to the moon, to look the moon, but till then no human beings entered to the moon. So when on 21 June 1969, Neil Armstrong became the first man to walk on the moon. Okay, so human beings sent so many spacecraft from 1960 to the moon, and it was a great desire of human beings to step on the moon. Okay, but it took so many years, around 9 years took, and in between the 9 years they have made so many plans, and they have a full setup to step into the moon. Okay, on 21 June 1969, the first man who visited and who stepped into the moon became the first man to walk on the moon was Neil Armstrong. strong. Okay, I hope you all got the point of the moon. Okay, let me just recollect what we have learned. Moon is the brightest and the largest thing which we see on the sky, because the reason why moon is so larger, because moon is the so much closer than any other planets to the earth. Okay, and now it takes 27 days and 8 hours to complete one revolution, and at the same time the period of rotation and the revolution are same for the moon. Okay, it takes 27 days and 8 hours for the rotation and for the revolution. Okay, here we have seen that because of this we see the same side of the moon. So because of it takes the same period, that's why we see the same phases of the moon. Okay, figure 1.7. You can look into your textbook, and that is this 1.7 will help you to understand. So the point X is the portion which faces to the earth. This is the earth. Okay, this is the earth and this is the point X, and it started the rotation from here. When it comes to here, and this part is getting the light, and it comes when it comes to here, and you can see it here, and there's here. The same face is coming to the facing to the earth, and when it again it rotates, and the figure 3, and the same face is facing to the earth, and when it comes to Uttaradi, the same face is facing to the earth. Okay, so that is that means that since it is rotating the same rate at which it is revolving, so it has also a completed quarter rotation. It is clear from the diagram that X or the moon still faces the earth. Okay, so when you look into the diagram, you can understand that wherever there are four diagrams are here, so you look each one of them, you can understand that still always the part X is facing towards the earth. Okay, so that is how we can understand that this is true, that the point in the moon's orbit. Okay, now moon is always light up one side, and when you see the moon in a complete phase and full phase, we say that is the Purnima or full moon day, and there is a gap in between this Purnima full moon and new moon. Okay, when there is no moon on the sky, we call the days as a new moon, and there is a 15 days gap in between the full moon and the new moon. Okay, and also I have said that there is no life on the moon, because there is human life or plants or animal needed a moderate temperature to live on. So the temperature is so much higher than the earth in the moon, that is why there is no life sustained on the moon. And so much dust and rocks are in the surface of the moon and descend them, and there is a circular depression called craters during 1960s. People sent so many spacecraft to the moon, and after 6 years, Neil Armstrong was the first man who walked on the moon. Hope you understood all about the moon. Now let's move to the next topic. Okay, let's go to the another topic. Another topic is the artificial satellites. Okay, you can see in your textbook page number 7, you can see the artificial satellites. Okay, so what is an artificial satellite? We have learned about the satellite, isn't it? Moon is also a satellite. Moon is a satellite of the earth. Okay, now we have already learned about the natural satellites. Satellites are of two types, natural satellites and the artificial satellites. What is an artificial satellite? Okay, an artificial satellite is an object designed to revolve around the earth or any other celestial body. What is an artificial satellite? Artificial satellite is an object designed to revolve around the earth or any other satellite. An object or anything which is designed to revolve around earth or any other heavenly bodies are known as a satellite. Artificial satellites means man made satellites. Okay, so how does it carry to the space? How can we carry it to the space? We can carry it to the space by a rocket. By the help of the rockets, we can carry the artificial satellites to the space. So it has so many uses such as you can might have heard about TV connecting the TV channels and giving telephone signals. That means when you have you use mobile phones, telephones such as you get you use the network. Okay, so that is coming by the connected by the satellites. Okay, so so many uses are the applications. Satellites have so many uses such as TV connection, telephone connections, and taking picture vast spaces picture. Sometimes you have seen the picture of Earth from a satellite. Okay, so such as there are so many uses of artificial satellites, and at the same time, I take the for pictures of the cloud. In cloud formation help the weather forecasting. So we have the weather forecasting for the phones, radios, and even to the television. So how does they forecast the weather? So they take the picture of the clouds and evaluate it, and then forecasting about the weather. So artificial satellites has so many uses. So India has an artificial satellite which is called InSat. InSat is the India's artificial satellites. They are also used for the communication of TV broadcasting. Okay, and other celestial bodies. So this is all about the artificial satellites. Now we can go to the other topic of the other celestial bodies. Okay, what are the other celestial bodies? As we have learned before, when we studied about the solar system, asteroids, meteoroids, comets are the other celestial bodies. Okay, so we have dwarf planet also. So the dwarf planet is a spherical celestial body that around orbit around, or means revolve around the sun. It is much smaller than the planet. Okay, dwarf planets are much smaller, spherical in shape, and that also revolve around the sun, and it is much smaller than the other planet. Okay, so even Pluto, Pluto is now considered as a dwarf planet because of its size. Okay, till the 1932 to 2006, Pluto was also a planet, and we saw we had 9 planets, but after 2006, Pluto is no more considered as a planet. It is considered as a dwarf planet. Ceres and Eris are two other dwarf planets. Okay, so those are about the other celestial dwarf planets. Now we have meteoroids. What are meteoroids? Okay, asteroids. Okay, we can go to the asteroids. The small celestial bodies moving around the sun between the Mars and the Jupiter. So when we say, I said that we have a inner planet and the outer planet. Okay, in between the inner planet and the outer planet, we have a space. Okay, what are the inner planets? Inner planets are Mercury, Venus, Earth, and the Mars are the inner planets. As we have learned in the previous videos, Mercury, Venus, Earth, and the Mars are the inner planets, and in between these inner planets and the outer planets, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune are the outer planets. These are the inner planets and these are the outer planets. So in between the outer planets and inner planets, there is a space. In that space, there are asteroids. Asteroids are also called the minor planets. Okay, so the asteroids are also the, called the minor planets, small planets. The small celestial body moving around the sun in between the Mars and the Jupiter. In between Mars and the Jupiter, small celestial body which move around the sun is called as asteroids. Okay, now asteroids are called also minor planets. Many astronomers believe that asteroids are fragments of planets which exploded a long time. Okay, next solution, other solution body is meteoroids. Meteoroids is a small pieces of rock that does revolve around the sun. So what does meteoroids? Meteoroids are the small pieces of rock revolve around the sun are known as meteoroids. And when meteoroids enter to the Earth's atmosphere, they start burning. Okay, when meteoroids comes on the Earth atmosphere, so we already the land that there is an earth is surrounded by a layer of air which is called atmosphere. So from the heavenly bodies, when meteoroids come enter to the earth atmosphere, it started to burn and then it would fall down to the earth. These burning pieces cause flash of lights they as they fall. So these burning pieces start flash when they falls to the earth. Okay, so we call them shooting stars or meteors. We call them shooting stars or the burning pieces are called shooting stars. Okay. Now most of the meteors burn up completely while it falls. So when it falls to the earth, when before reaching the earth, most of the meteors completely burns up. Okay, a meteor survives its falls and hits ground is called a meteor. Okay, so a meteor that survives its fall, that hits the ground, is called a meteor. Okay, what is meteoroids? Meteoroids is a meteor which falls from the sky, and if it survives without burning completely, most of the meteoroids, what happens, when it comes, already I have said that meteoroids are the celestial body, and when it comes to the earth, falls from the sky and come to the earth atmosphere, okay, came here, and here it starts to burn, okay, starting to burn. So then most of it burns completely before reaching the earth, okay, in the atmosphere itself, it completely burns up, and some of them survives. Not all of them, some very few of them survives. So all few of them survives are called meteoroids. Okay. Now we have another. So in years ago, so many years back, a meteoroid fall on the USA, which is in Arizona, that about 50,000 years back, a meteoroid created a very big crater. Means very big dig in USA, which is in Arizona, which is in USA. Okay, now we have comets. Okay, what are comets? Comets revolve around the sun in lower elliptical path. Okay, so something which heavenly body which is revolving around the sun in a long elliptical path are known as comets. Okay, when comet comes near to the sun, it started to glow. When comet comes near to the sun, it started to glow, and it takes years to complete their orbit. It takes so many years to complete one orbit. That is why, therefore, we can see this only after so many years. Do you understand? Okay, so these are the other heavenly bodies, other celestial bodies. The other celestial bodies, there are dwarf planets are there, asteroids are there, meteoroids are there, comets are there. I hope you understood all of this. Okay, now let us recollect what we have learned in this class. We have learned about the moon in this class, and moon is the large heavenly body, as I have already told you. Like in this portion, we have learned about the artificial satellites. What is an artificial satellite? Artificial satellite is an object that revolves around the earth or any other celestial bodies which is made by man. Okay, so there are so many uses. The artificial satellites are taken to the space by the support of a rocket. We have India has a satellite, and its name is INSAT, is the India satellite, and it is used for TV communication, TV broadcasting, and telephone connection, and such as so many uses it has. Okay, and then we have learned about the other celestial bodies. So we have learned about the dwarf planet, and now Pluto is also a dwarf planet. Dwarf planet is smaller than the other planets, and it is spherical in shape, and it orbits the sun. Okay, now we have asteroids. Asteroids are also considered as a minor planet and a small celestial body moving around the sun in between the Mars and the Jupiter is called the asteroids. Okay, what are meteoroids? Meteoroids are small pieces of rock dust revolve around the sun. Small pieces of rock and dust revolve around the sun are called as meteoroids. And meteoroids reaches to the earth. When it reaches to the earth's atmosphere, it starts to burn. And when it burns, some of them burn up and stuff there itself. And very few of them survive from their burning and fall onto the earth. Okay, so such as when the burning pieces are called the shooting stars, and when the surviving pieces are called the meteoroids. That means the meteoroids that survive as it falls and hits the ground. Okay, now at last we have learned about the comets. What are comets? Comets are the celestial body which revolve around the sun in a long elliptical path. Long elliptical path it revolves, and when it comes near to the sun, it starts to glow. And a comet takes thousands of years to complete its orbit, and that is why we can see it after so many years. Okay, this is all our part we have learned in this class, and I hope you understood the first chapter. We are going to end the first chapter, and our universe is a very big and vast space. We have so many things to study about it. We have studied a small every year scientist researcher and bringing up so many new things about the earth. So let's wait for the other scientific resource which we can learn in upcoming years. I hope you understood all about the first chapter. We studied in the first chapter about the stars. What are the stars? Celestial body which produce their own light is called stars. And we studied about the constellation. Constellation is the group of stars which form a definite shape. Then we have studied about the galaxy. Then studied about the solar system, satellites, asteroids, meteoroids, comets, and artificial satellites, such as so many things we learned. I hope you all will study all of this and do the exercises which is given in your textbook. Those who are textbook can do it, and for others we will send us the PDF file. So study well, make homework, make note of all this. I hope you understood this first chapter. Thank you for watching me. We will meet in the next video. God bless you.